What's up, YouTube? It's Machanga, back with another video. So the Lenovo ThinkPad X1 Yoga isn't your normal consumer laptop. It's a 14-inch 2-in-1 convertible aimed at the business professional. If you work in IT or if you're responsible for purchasing employee laptops, you've probably heard the ThinkPad name more than a few times. In this review, I'm going to talk about who I think should consider buying this laptop because there are some great features like Linux support and LTE that might make it worth the premium asking price. Anything I mention in this video will be linked below in the video description. As someone that appreciates the durability and reliability of ThinkPads in general, it's easy for me to recommend them. This machine has that classic understated design that fits perfectly in a corporate environment, but it also stands up great to travel and heavy field use. I don't have any hesitation throwing this into my backpack or handing it to my assistant for taking notes or sketching out a storyboard. The overall look of this laptop is very minimal and sleek. It's iron gray and made from CNC aluminum, plus it's been tested against 12 military grade requirements, so it can withstand things like spills, drops, storms, and pretty much whatever else you might have to deal with out in the field. Many of us are working from home right now, so you don't have to worry about babying your laptop when you need to carry it from one room to the next. It's a convertible laptop, so a rigid hinge is needed for it to last, and Lenovo did a great job with the 360-degree hinge on this one. While we're talking about the design, the display on this laptop is amazing. There are several display options available, but my review unit has the 14-inch 4K touch IPS panel that is HDR compatible. It measures just under 500 nits of brightness and has Dolby Vision. With 100% sRGB coverage, it has great color accuracy. Once you're done looking at spreadsheets, graphs, and emails all day, you can look forward to enjoying some movies or TV shows on this laptop. Now, I do have a tiny complaint about the display. Lenovo has taken some steps to make it anti-reflective, but it's still glossy. You will still get reflections, but a great way to combat those are just by cranking up the brightness. I love a matte display, but if you want that HDR certification, there's no way around the gloss. Now, another small gripe I have is the 16:9 aspect ratio. I feel like business laptops specifically should all be 16:10 or 3:2, but maybe next year. Some may complain about the larger chin at the bottom of the display, but I feel like it's a good thing on a convertible laptop that you intend to use in tablet mode. You need to have something to hold on to. Looking at connectivity, there are plenty of ports on this laptop as you would expect from a business class machine. On the right side, we have a Thunderbolt 3 port that also charges the laptop, another Thunderbolt 3 port, a proprietary network extension port for Ethernet, or a mechanical docking station. We also have a USB Type-A port, a HDMI port, and the headphone microphone combo jack. On the left, we get the Kensington lock slot, another USB Type-A port, the power button, and the ThinkPad Pen Pro garage in the side here. So I have a love-hate relationship with this pen. I love how convenient it is to slide it in and out of the pen storage slot. I feel like more convertible laptops should implement this type of pen since it's much harder to misplace it. What I don't like as much is the size of the pen. It reminds me of a Galaxy Note pen, but I will say it's easy to jot down notes, sign documents, or even sketch and color with it. It uses Wacom technology, so it's a good pen as long as you're not expecting professional artist quality lines and pressure sensitivity. I never had to worry about charging it since it charges while it's inside the pen slot. I love it much more than I hate it. In my opinion, it's one of the main reasons to get this laptop. So let's talk about audio real quick. The speaker system on this laptop is great. It's actually excellent because the sound is coming from such a thin chassis. This X1 Yoga has a Dolby Atmos speaker system. There are two upward firing tweeters along with two downward firing woofers. You get the full range here, mids, lows, and highs. It's clear and it's crisp. Whether you're watching movies or listening to music, surprisingly, the speakers deliver. I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time talking about the keyboard because it is a legendary ThinkPad keyboard, but I think the constant slimming of the ultrabooks is starting to affect the integrity of keyboards in general. I'm hoping Lenovo doesn't take slim and light too far in upcoming generations. I type on a ThinkPad every single day, and nothing else in laptop form can really compare. The U-shaped keys just feel like they were molded for your fingers. You get great key travel and actuation. This is backlit with white backlighting, and it's plenty bright. Something that continues to keep my attention on ThinkPad keyboards is the TrackPoint. I know it gets ignored by a lot of people, and some people even complain it's harder to use or simply useless. I could not disagree more. If you take that time in the beginning to use it and learn the feel of it, you will realize that it can help you get things done faster. Now, I wouldn't use it while editing videos since I found the keyboard and mouse combo to be faster for that, but everything else, the TrackPoint is a winner. This precision trackpad is a decent size, plus it's smooth and responsive with all the Windows 10 gestures. I love the physical buttons here above the trackpad because they function as a unit with the TrackPoint. Moving to the top, we have the 720p webcam. The quality isn't great, and I do feel like it should be bumped up in resolution in the next generation X1 Yoga. But you do get the physical switch or privacy shutter called the ThinkShutter for covering the webcam when it's not in use. There's also Windows Hello technology included, and I use that every day to log into my ThinkPad P1. Oh, and the microphones on this laptop are great. We get four 360-degree microphones that work well to cancel out background noise when you're on calls, and they're also great at picking up your voice when you want to wake the computer up. If you prefer to use a fingerprint instead, there's a fast, accurate, match-on-chip fingerprint reader included right next to the trackpad. A big selling point for this caliber of laptop is the added security features. The ThinkShield security features that not only include the webcam cover and the fingerprint reader, but also the discrete trusted platform module, or DTPM, that encrypts your data, works alongside Windows 10 security. In addition to those I just mentioned, there's also the option for a privacy guard, which is an electronic privacy filter built into the screen that works to decrease the angle of vision. Just keep in mind that you'll need to stick with the 1920 by 1080 full HD display to get that privacy filter. Now, I'm not well versed in all things Linux, but I do know that there are some huge advantages to using it over Windows or even Mac OS. If you prefer Linux, specifically Ubuntu, you can purchase the X1 Yoga with Linux already installed. Developers and engineers that I've encountered like working in a Linux environment, so that might be something to consider if you're still on the fence about adding this machine to your workflow. Starting at $1,400 US will probably put this laptop out of the reach of many university students, but if you have the budget for it and you're studying graphic design, cloud and IoT development, coding, or engineering, this is a premium, robust option. Let's get a quick look at the internals. I was disappointed to see the RAM soldered on because business laptops should be user upgradable and easily repaired by replacing components. To make matters a bit worse for me is the inclusion of DDR3 RAM instead of the faster DDR4. In real world use, I didn't notice any adverse effects of running this RAM, but it just would have been an easier pill to swallow for the price of this X1 Yoga. It was good to see the Wi-Fi 6 card installed, so it's about as future-proof as technology can really be in this ever-growing market. I've had consistently strong speeds and stable connections. The NVMe SSD is a fast one, so I have no complaints there, but you can swap it out for a higher capacity if you like. I don't have it on my review unit, but you can add the optional LTE WAN card, so you don't have to worry about searching for a decent Wi-Fi signal away from the office. You can see the 51 watt hour battery here. I got around 9 hours of battery life with mixed use and 50% screen brightness. Depending on the type of user you are, you could squeeze out a bit more, I'm sure. One of the reasons to buy this is for the portability and not having to be tethered to the power adapter. Once the battery does get low, though, the X1 Yoga does support rapid charge with the included 65-watt AC adapter. Moving on to performance, the machine I have here is running the Intel Core i7 10610U processor. Lenovo stuck with this previous generation CPU instead of Ice Lake to maintain vPro compatibility. If you're not familiar with Intel vPro, it's a platform that offers more security and stability between hardware and software for business users. Keeping this CPU also means living with Intel 620 UHD integrated graphics, which just aren't that great. Iris Plus graphics would have offered much better GPU performance. Looking at the numbers though, the CPU performance is good and exactly where it should be in order to compete with similar laptops using Ice Lake processors. For programmers or developers and IT management, this is a good performing laptop. I had no issues with thermals. The temperatures of both the CPU and GPU are well managed. The laptop never got too hot for using on my lap or when folded into tablet mode. As usual, when using performance mode, the fans will ramp up faster and slightly louder, but still nothing unbearable, and you can easily use this in the office. If you prefer a more balanced experience, just use the default mode instead. My overall experience with the new ThinkPad X1 Yoga Gen 5 has been positive. The negatives may be deal breakers for some, but not me. There's no SD card reader, the integrated graphics haven't been updated, and the screen is not matte. With that being said, this laptop has a lot going for it if it fits within your budget, especially if you're looking to purchase for your team. The performance is good, the display options are great, it has a nice pen, fantastic audio, optional LTE, Linux pre-installed, and all-day battery life. If you don't need high graphics performance and your work relies mostly on CPU use, I can easily recommend this laptop. That's going to wrap it up for this one. If you're interested in the new ThinkPad X1 Nano and ThinkPad X1 Fold, I'll definitely be reviewing both of those soon. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you feel like it, jump down in the comment section and let me know you like it. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and make sure you tap the bell icon so you'll be notified every time I post new videos. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.